to him. Hallelujah. Come on, tell him how much you love him. Tell him how much you need him. Come on, let's allow this place to ring with your praise and your adoration unto God. We love you, God. We call you Abba Father. That's what we call you. We call you Abba Father. We love you. We magnify you. In the mighty name of Jesus, thank you for making us more like you, God. In the name of Jesus, you are our Abba Father. Come on, I want to challenge you in your own way. Come on, tell them, I love you, God. I love you, God. I'm so infatuated with you, Holy Spirit. We can't do this without you, Holy Spirit. Be with us. We call upon your name. I dare you to scream it out. Say, Abba. For Christ is risen. How many of y'all believe that we serve a risen God? How many of y'all believe we serve a risen Savior? How many of y'all believe that we serve a risen King? How many of y'all believe that we serve a powerful God? How many of y'all believe that He's the one and only true and living God? If you believe that we serve the one and only true and living God, I want you to give Him a one and only true and living shout. If He's powerful, give Him praise. If He's mighty, give Him praise. If He's all-knowing, we give Him praise. Acknowledge Him for who He is. We acknowledge you. I have the hugest smile on my face. I hope my teeth is white.
Go ahead.
Because I love it when we have an encounter with the presence of God. Don't you love it? Don't you love it? Do you love it? Ask your neighbor, do you love it? When you come in encounter, when you come in contact with the presence of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's what it's all about.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You can keep it playing for a little bit, brother. Amen. We bless your name. We honor you, God. Hallelujah. If you have your Bible or your cell phone, while we remain standing, go ahead and get it out. Anything that you use to read the Word of God, go ahead and get it out. Amen. Hallelujah. And we're, how many of y'all are ready for the Word? Yeah, I can tell. The Holy Spirit said yes. Come on. We've already welcomed the Holy Spirit during praise and worship and prayer. Hallelujah. So we're going to dive. We're going to go deeper. Everybody say, go deep.
Let's go deep.
Come on, because this is the Word.
Yes,
the Word of God, the only thing that is real. Yay and amen.
Yes,
the only thing that is real. Amen. Yes, hallelujah. Yes, because the Word of God gives us access to the presence of God.
Yes,
and the process, the presence of God gives us access to the higher things of God. How many of y'all want to go higher?
Yes,
come on. How many of you want your hunger to go higher?
Yes,
your passion to go higher?
Yes,
your thirst for more of Him to go higher? The way we do that is access His presence.
Yes,
amen. Lift up your Bibles. Lift them up in the earth. Come on. Father God, we thank you for this Word.
Thank you, Lord.
Come on. Join in with me. Y'all aren't here for me because I'm a wretch undone. We're doing this together. I want you on a count of three just to lift up your voice and say, thank you for this Word, God. One, two, three, go. Just say, thank you for this Word. Thank you for this Word. Come on, say, I need this Word. I'm thirsting for this Word. Come on. Thank you that this Word is going to be planted in my heart. And it's going to grow and mature into the tools that I need to go higher in you. Come on. Tell the Holy Spirit, I love this Word. I need this Word. I've been waiting for this Word. Thank you, Abba Father, for giving us another opportunity to read your Word. Come on. Hallelujah. We bless your name. And if you believe that, for the next 30 seconds, give God a hand clap and a shout of praise. Hallelujah. We bless your name. While you're at it, high five three people. And tell them, I've got a heavenly Father, and I call them Abba. Come on, I have a heavenly Father. Come on, high five three people. I got a heavenly Father. Amen. We got a heavenly Father. There we go. We got a heavenly Father. We got a heavenly Father. Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes, I see you. We got a heavenly Father. Yes. We got a heavenly Father. Hallelujah. We bless your name, God.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Yes, Lord.
Everybody says amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Turn with me to Romans chapter 8.
Amen.
Romans chapter 8.
Yes,
I will not be before you long. But I choose to believe the way the word is presented is predicated on how you want the word of God, your thirst and your hunger for the word of God. Amen. And the Holy Spirit is saying, thank you for making me feel welcome.
Amen.
Even during the praise and worship, you made him feel welcome.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Minister Laria said it right. It's not about us. It's not about the environment. It's not about people doing it for a show. It's about a true, authentic experience with the Holy Spirit. Because that's the only thing that is sure. Amen.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, we need the Holy Spirit.
We need the Holy Spirit.
That's it. That's it. That's it. Romans chapter 8, and I really feel led to read verses 1 through 16, and it really blessed me. And I normally don't preach a sermon based on a particular holiday or whatever celebrated, but I always strive to be obedient to what the Holy Spirit wants me to do, and he wanted me to remind us how precious it is to have a heavenly Father. How many of y'all believe that today?
Yes,
we are so thankful. How many of you are thankful that we have a heavenly Father? I know I'm thankful. Amen. It's because of my heavenly Father, I am able to be a father to my two boys. And we have fathers presented today. It's because of our heavenly Father, we can call ourselves sons of God. And our women of God, they can call each other daughters of God because we have a heavenly Father that is concerned about our well-being. How many of y'all believe that today?
Hallelujah.
And I believe that Romans chapter 6, verses 1 through 16 is the prime example or the prime illustration of what it means to have a relationship with our heavenly Father. Amen?
Amen.
And it says here, I'm going to read verses 1 through 16. And it says, verse 1, chapter 8 in Romans. Therefore, there is now no condemnation, no guilty verdict, no punishment. Isn't that a glorious honor? There is no condemnation, no guilty verdict, no punishment to those who are in Christ Jesus, who believe in him as personal Lord and Savior. Raise your hand if you believe that's you. But based on this word, there's no condemnation for those of us, amen, who call on his name. There's no guilty verdict. There is no punishment to those who are in Christ Jesus. Verse 2, for the law of the Spirit of life, which is in Christ Jesus, the law of our new being has set you free from the law of sin and death. Isn't that a glorious honor? For verse 3 says, for what the law could not do, that is, overcome sin and remove penalty, its power being weakened by the flesh, man's nature without the Holy Spirit. But God did. Everybody say God did.
God did.
He sent his own son in the likeness of a sinful man as an offering for sin. And he condemned sin in the flesh, meaning he subdued it and became it in the person of his own son. Verse 4, so that the righteous and just, raise your hand if you're righteous and just. Raise your hand if you strive each and every day to be righteous and just. So based on what Jesus did on the cross, so that the righteous and just, everybody say, that's me.
That's
it. Requirement of the law might be fulfilled in us who do not live our lives in the way of the flesh, guided by worldliness or sinful nature, but lives in the ways of the Spirit, guided by his power. Come on, how many of y'all want to be guided by his power? How many of y'all want to be guided by the Spirit of the true and living God? So verse 5 will really bless you. It says here, for those who are living according to the flesh set their minds on the things of the flesh, which gratify the body. But those who are living according to the Spirit set their minds on the things of the Spirit with will and purpose. Now the mind of the flesh is death. Everybody say death. Both now and forever, because it pursues sin. Everybody say sin. But the mind of the Spirit is life. Everybody say life.
Life.
And peace. the spiritual well-being that comes from walking with God, both now and forever. Raise your hand if you're striving to walk with God. Amen. Verse 7 says, the mind of the flesh, which is sinful pursuits, is actively hostile to God. Everybody say no. Everybody say no. Everybody say because. Everybody say, I'm walking in the Spirit. There you go. It does not submit itself to God's law, since it cannot. And those who are in the flesh, living a life that caters to sinful appetites and impulses, cannot please God. Everybody say, however. Loud and clear. However. Verse 9 says, however, you are not living in the flesh, controlled by sinful nature, but in the Spirit. How many of y'all are thankful for that right now? If, in fact, the Spirit of God lives in you, raise your hand if the Spirit of God lives in you. I want you to ask your neighbor, does the Spirit of God live in you? Ask him, does the Spirit of God live in you? Does the Spirit of God live in you? But it says, if the Spirit of God lives in you, directing and guiding you. But if anyone does not have the Spirit of Christ, he does not belong to him, as is not a child of God. If Christ lives in you through your natural body, though your natural body is dead because of sin, your spirit is alive because of righteousness, because he provides us. Give God a hand clap of praise if you're glad that you are living a life of righteousness and striving each and every day, because the only way you can do that is by living by the Spirit. Amen. I want you to skip down to verse 14. I want you to underline this. For all who are allowing themselves to be led by the Spirit of God are sons of God, or daughters of God. Amen. Verse 15 says, for you have not received the spirit of slavery, leading again to fear of God's judgment, but you have received the spirit of adoption as sons, the Spirit introducing sonship, by which we joyfully cry. Everybody say, Abba Father. Loud and clear. Abba Father. The Spirit himself testifies and confirms together with our spirit, assuring us that we believers are children of God. If you believe that, say amen.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, we are children of God. Amen. And raise your hand if you're living by the Spirit of God. So therefore, when you're living by the, you can't be seated, amen. Therefore, if we're living by the Spirit of God, we can call ourselves sons and daughter of the Most High God, amen. Go tell your neighbor, I'm a son of God. I'm a daughter of God. Amen. Because we strive each and every day to live by the Spirit of God. And what the Word of God says is, when we live by the Spirit of God, we are adopted as sons and daughters of God. And when we're adopted as sons and daughters of God, we can cry out, Abba, Father. When you look up the word Abba in the Hebrew, it means I am adopted. Are you hearing me? Meaning, we have our natural fathers, but boy, is it a wonderful feeling to know that we are adopted by the only one that is powerful. We are adopted by the only one that is holy. We are adopted by the only one that is yea and amen. We are adopted by the one who made the universe. We are adopted by the one that has everything under control. We are adopted by the true and only power source, which is our heavenly Father. Amen. And the Holy Spirit led me to Romans because Paul was describing our life in the Spirit. Before knowing Jesus, our life was in the flesh. Amen. We followed the desires of the flesh. How many of y'all believe that? You know, we were following those desires. We were following the demands of the law. After trusting in and becoming a follower of Jesus, that means Paul was saying that the Spirit of God dwells in you. I want you to tell your neighbor, the Spirit of God dwells in you. Come on, tell him, the Spirit of God dwells in you. You know, and I want to make that proclamation because everybody raised their hand and said that they accepted Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. They believe in the one and only true and risen King. So if that is you, you are striving each and every day to live by the Spirit. And when we live by the Spirit, we are children of the Most High God. Amen. Hallelujah. And guess what? We are no longer enslaved to our flesh. Meaning this thing, right here, our skin, our actual body, whether it be buff or not, this thing, you know, it causes us to be slave unto the flesh. It causes us to be slaves unto sin. But guess what? When we are adopted into the sonship or the daughtership of God, we are no longer enslaved to this flesh. How many of y'all are glad about that? Meaning we have a will and we have a way to stay righteous and uphold and righteous and holy. Amen. We have a will and a way to stay on the straight and narrow. We have a will and a way to do right.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Don't y'all believe that? Because we can't do right in and of ourselves.
Yeah.
That's good.
We may want to do right, but the word of God says this flesh inherently wants to do wicked. How many of y'all believe that there's a war on the inside of us?
Amen.
You know, your mind, how many have ever walked in, you know, you're just minding your business and all of a sudden your mind just went in left field.
Yes, sir.
And you're like, where did that thought come from? And you're like, I rebuke that thought in the name of Jesus. The reason why those ungodly thoughts come in your mind just like that, because we are in a host called this flesh who inherently wants to do evil against God. But raise your hand if the Spirit of God lives on the inside of you. The reason why we strive to do right is because the Spirit of the true and living God gives us the ability to do right, gives us the power to do right, because we are a child of God.
Thank you.
Amen. Yes. How many of y'all believe that today?
Amen.
So before we adopted into the sonship and daughtership of God, we were inherently sinful. We were living by the flesh. We couldn't operate in the fruits of the Spirit. We couldn't really operate in joy. We couldn't really operate in peace. We couldn't really operate in meekness. Amen. You say, well, Vince, I'm a good person. Well, you know, the Bible says that you can't inherently be a good person without the Spirit of God living on the inside of you. And even when the Spirit of God is living on the inside of you, guess what? There's always a war on the inside. But I want you to repeat after me. In the name of Jesus. That's it. My spirit will be stronger. And I will stay on the side that is pleasing the Lord. Come on, tell your spirit man that. I will stay on the side that is pleasing to the Lord. Because guess what? You are my Abba Father. Say, God, you are my Abba Father. Amen. Hallelujah. Can't you tell the difference, though? When you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you're being more conscious of some things. The way you think. Amen. The way you act. When I came into the realization that everything that comes out of my mouth is a seed that is planted into somebody, and when I begin to come into the realization every word that is coming out of my mouth, everything that I'm speaking to people is actually planting seeds on the inside of people. Everything that is coming out of my mouth right now is actually planting seeds into your spirit, man. When I came into the realization of that, I began to be more conscious of what I say. I began to be more conscious of my countenance, all because I was beginning and starting to live in the Spirit. Everybody say, live in the Spirit.
Amen.
Come on, you should feel the difference. Amen?
Amen.
Because now you have a higher power working on the inside of you. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. You have the power of the Spirit of God operating on the inside of you. You have the power of the Spirit of God telling you don't go that way. You have the power of the Spirit of God telling you don't go up that mountain, or to stay here, or don't hang out with that person, or don't do this. You know, there's a war on the inside. But raise your hand if you know that you're going to be victorious.
Amen.
You are going to be victorious. Why? Because the Spirit of the true and living God is on the inside of you. Meaning this flesh was put to death. Come on. I want you to point to your flesh and say, flesh.
Flesh.
Say, flesh.
Flesh.
Die.
Die.
Come on, tell them, flesh.
Flesh.
Die.
Because
I want to be in right standing.
Amen.
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 If our Heavenly Father, if we call Him Abba Father, we want to do everything that we can do or need to do to be in right standing. How many of y'all believe that? How many of y'all know that's you? It's like me. Oh, Vince, you know, I want to be in right standing. You know, when my flesh wants to sin, I'll be like, flesh is not even worth it. God, I love you. God, I thank you. I want to be in right standing. I want to be holy. I want to be pure. I want to be acceptable.
Yes,
why?
Amen.
Because you're my Abba Father.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. How many of y'all believe that? Amen.
Amen.
And you know, today is Father's Day. Hallelujah. Y'all give a hand clap of praise for all the fathers here. We got Daddy Hayes. We got Brother Broderick. We got Brother Battle. We got Brother Kelton. Amen. We have some spiritual fathers here. Amen. It's good to see Brother Broderick's son. Welcome in. Give God a hand clap of praise for Brother Broderick's son. Amen. We bless God. You know, today is Father's Day. And when I was spending some time with the Lord, I thought he said this scripture was very appropriate. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah, because we have a Heavenly Father. Amen.
Amen.
Some of us, we have great experiences with our Father. I know I do. I remember my dad used to spank me, amen, when I got out of line. And he used to make me read all these long novels in the summer. I used to be mad with my dad. Everybody out there playing ball, Dad. Why I got to read this book? You know, man. And I would have a temper tantrum. You know, I would walk into my room. And I'm like, why do you have me do this, God? But when I think back on what my dad did, I begin to be thankful. I just got off the phone with him during the last song of praise and worship, and he's having church service, and I just say, Dad, I thank you. Dad, I love you. You were the one that introduced me to the presence of God. I thank you for everything that you've done. It was because of my dad. Amen. My dad was tough. It was tough love, but also there was love. It was love. He always let me know, son, I love you.
Cool.
Son, I'm backing you up. I'll never forget when there were teachers telling my mom and dad that I wouldn't amount to anything. It was my dad that rose up and said, not my son. You better not talk against my son. He can do all things through Christ, who strengthens him. He was the one that gave me the catalyst and the backbone to let me know that I have everything on the inside of me. That's what a dad does. Amen. And we have, that's what our human fathers does. And there are some fathers that aren't so good. Amen. But even though, we as dads, I'm a father. We don't get it right all the time. You know, I remember one time I was chastising my son, Micah, and I came on a little too harsh, and my son was scared of me, and I said, whoa, did I do something wrong? And I had to reassure him, son, I love you. I really do. And reassure, you know, we don't get it all the way right. Am I right, dads?
Amen.
We don't get it all the way right.
Amen.
Sometimes we fall short. Why? Because we're in this flesh. But guess what? When the Spirit of the true living God is living on the inside of you, we can go to our Abba Father and say, God, help me to be the man that you want me to be so I can lead my family in the way that you would be pleasing. I have people that are dependent on me. That's what a true father does. Can y'all back me up right now? If you are a father in the house and you strive each and every day to do things right, we turn to our Heavenly Father.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And the reason why we have a Heavenly Father, because we're adopted. Everybody say, we're adopted. Everybody say, we're adopted. Amen. Not just sons, but daughters. We are adopted as children. Everybody turn with me to Romans chapter 8, verses 14 through 16. Are you guys being blessed thus far?
Amen.
All right. Praise God. Hey, praise God. I'm just giving you what the Holy Spirit wanted me to give you. Amen.
You.
Hallelujah. Romans chapter 8, verses 14 through 16. I'm going to give you some proof why we're adopted. Amen.
Amen.
If you proclaim Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, this word right here gives you proof that we are adopted. It says here in verse 14, for all who are following, allowing themselves to be led by the Spirit of God. Raise your hand. Is that you? I just want to make sure. For all who are allowing themselves to be led by the Spirit of God are sons of God. And I know it uses the term sons of God, but that means all genders. Amen. Sons and daughters of God. How many of y'all believe that, right?
Yeah.
And verse 15 says, for you have not received the spirit of slavery, leading again to fear of God's judgment, but you have received the spirit of adoptions as sons, the spirit introducing sonship by which we joyfully cry, Abba Father. Everybody say, Abba Father.
Abba Father.
The Spirit himself testifies and confirms together with our spirit, assuring us that we believers are children of the Most High. If we trust in Jesus, we're God's children. If we lean on Jesus, we're God's children. If we trust in Him and if we are led by the Spirit of God, we are God's children. All of us are His creation, but those who were led by the Spirit are called His children. The only way a person can become a child of God is through faith in Jesus Christ. The only way we can call ourselves children of God is through our faith in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Do you have faith in Jesus Christ?
Yes,
ask your neighbor, do you have faith in Jesus Christ?
Yes,
come on. Do you have faith? Do you have faith? Do you have faith in Jesus Christ? Amen?
Amen.
So when we have faith with Jesus Christ, turn with me to John chapter 1, verses 12 through 13. And when you get it, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That's it. John chapter 1, verses 12 through 13. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I really hope and pray you're being blessed today. Amen.
Amen.
John chapter 1, verses 12 through 13. Everybody say, Abba Father.
Abba Father.
There you go. Verse 12 says this, but to as many as did receive and welcome him, he gave the right, the authority, the privilege to become children of God. That is, to those who believe in, adhere to, trust in, and rely on His name, who were born not of blood, meaning natural conception, nor of the will of the flesh, meaning physical impulse, nor by the will of man, that is, of a natural father, but of God, say, everybody say, but of God.
God.
That is a divine and supernatural birth, that we are born of God, spiritually transformed. Everybody say transformed.
Transformed.
Spiritually renewed. Everybody say renewed.
Renewed.
And spiritually sanctified. Everybody say sanctified.
Sanctified.
Come on, give a God a hand clap of praise, because He is saying that when we become a son or a daughter of a Most High God, we have authority. Everybody say authority.
Authority.
Everybody say privilege.
Privilege.
We have a privilege. How many of y'all love privileges? I know I do.
Amen.
All right, two for ones, right? Amen.
Yeah.
Right? When you go to New York and Company, you get those little coupons. That's a privilege. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. That's it. Right now, my sons, they love Wendy's. Right now, the kids' meals are $2. That's a privilege. Because they want Wendy's every day. That's a privilege. It's cheap.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Everybody say privileges.
Privileges.
But you know, amen. But as believers, we enjoy all the privileges, all the obligations, and the inheritance of the rights of being children of God. Come on, we have a right. We have some rights as children of God. We have some inheritances as children of God. We have some blessings as children of God. When we say Abba Father, when we call Him Abba Father, everything comes with it. When we say Abba Father, you know what God does? He says, you know what? That's my daughter, Miss Williams. Yes, come on in. That's my son, Brother Broderick. Come on in. He's actually has a signed seal approval. When you say Abba Father, oh, wait a minute. Robert Battle is calling my name. Legion of angels come to his aid. You know what? Because he's letting every demon in hell know that my son or my daughter is calling on me when I need them. And guess what? It's letting every demon in hell know that's a marked child when he called Abba Father. Because when you call Abba Father, the Holy Spirit testifies, gives you a sign of approval that you're his.
Yes. Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Why? Because his spirit is on the inside of you.
Thank you.
And your spirit, man, testifies with the Holy Spirit. When you know two spirits are joined together, they testify with each other. And guess what? He comes to your aid. Amen. When Micah calls my name, when he's dealing with a bad dream, he's like, Daddy, I'm scared. And even though I'm tired with dried slobber down the side of my lip, I'm coming in running. Son, what you need? That's what God does. God, I need your help. He comes running. God, I need your deliverance. He comes running. God, I need your peace. He comes running. Amen. Because your spirit man is coming in contact with the Holy Spirit, and then he comes to your aid when you say, Abba, Father.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
We are adopted.
Yes.
And it's not just a regular adoption. Mm-hmm. Amen. You know, when you think of a regular adoption, you go through all this paperwork, and then when you go through all these checks, amen, and then you go into this new home, you think about that, right? I've never been adopted, but I was reading up on what the process of what happens when you go through adoption. It's a long, arduous process. Are y'all hearing me? It's a long, arduous process. Meaning if you want to adopt a child, you got to go through this paperwork. You got to go through a background check. And you got, and then the agencies make sure that everything is in place before you can adopt that little boy or that little girl. But I want to tell you something. And then guess what? When they finally come into your home, it's like that child is like, yes, I have a home.
Amen.
Yes, I have some place to go.
Amen.
Yes, I have somebody who cares for you. Did you know that Jesus Christ did that on the cross 2,000 years ago? He comes in. We were disconnected from our Heavenly Father, and Jesus goes through the arduous process of signifying who he was in the Spirit, so that now that when we call on him, he already went through that process. He already went through that background check. And when we finally accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, guess what? He adopts us. He invites us into his presence. And we finally have an authentic experience with the presence of God. We're like, yes, we're finally home.
Thank you,
amen.
Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you.
And then our spirit testifies with his spirit, and we feel at home.
Yeah.
How many of y'all ever felt this way? When you finally come in contact and have a true experience with the Holy Spirit, we have a sense of relief. There's a sense of belonging. There's a void that is all of a sudden filled when you were trying everything else to fill that void.
Yeah.
Now we're complete.
Amen.
Why? Because we came back in contact.
Glory.
With our Heavenly Father.
Amen. Amen.
Everybody say, Abba Father.
Abba Father.
Abba Father. Hallelujah. Romans 8 and 17 says, if children, then heirs. Heirs of God and fellow heirs with Christ, provided we suffer with him in order that we may be glorified in him. That's Romans 8 and 17. When we suffer with our Heavenly Father, you know what? You know, he's with us.
Yes,
how many of y'all been through some sufferings?
Yes,
yeah, there are some sufferings we go through that are our fault, but there's also some sufferings that we go through when we're his children. But I want to encourage you today that he is with you. God said he will never leave you. He will never forsake you. And guess what? When we suffer with him, we reign with him because we're heirs of the Most High God. You know what an heir means? That we have everything. We have an inheritance. Amen. There's an inheritance. Amen. Didn't Jesus say, I go and prepare a place for you? Amen. So we cannot imagine what's waiting for us. And we cannot imagine what's waiting for us even here as a son or a daughter of God. Everything that God has for us spiritually. Amen. We have hope. Give God a hand clap of praise if you have at least an ounce of hope. Because there's so many people out there that don't.
Room.
But we have hope.
Yes.
Knowing that everything is going to be all right.
Amen.
When we suffer with him, we reign with him. Come on.
Amen.
When we suffer with him, we reign with him. And then guess what? We will be glorified. Everybody say glorified.
Glorified.
Come on. We have a glorified body. We have glorified experiences.
Thank you.
We have a glorified walk with him. We have a glorified lifestyle. All because we've been adopted as an heir of the Most High God.
Thank you, Abba Father.
Yes.
That's
hallelujah.
It.
Yes.
Amen. Do you hear what the Holy Spirit is saying?
Yes. God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And that's what salvation gives us. Amen.
Yes.
We all are familiar with that salvation prayer, but it's one thing to pray that prayer, but it's another thing to really pray that prayer and mean it. We want to be heirs of God.
Yes, sir.
Amen. We don't want to be bamboozled or going astray. Amen. Hallelujah. We want to be heirs of God. And when you would be like, well, Pastor Vince, I didn't have a good experience with my father. Pastor Vince, I never knew my father. Or Pastor Vince, you know, you don't know what I've been through. But I'm here to tell you by the Spirit of God that you have a father that never left you, never forsaked you. You have a father that has been through those tough, turbulent times the same time you've been through them. And all you have to do is call on his name, and every void that you've been looking to be filled, he will fill it instantaneously. When you come in contact with your Abba Father, you have a tangible experience with his presence. We have a tangible experience with his power. You have a tangible experience with who he is.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Everybody in here, I believe you believe in God. But God is saying, I want everybody in here to have a tangible experience with me.
He's real.
You know, he's not just a God that is way up there. Hey, God.
There you go.
Hey, how you doing? Uh-huh. You're way up there. God's like, no, I want to be chilling with you.
Amen.
I want to talk to you.
Amen.
I want to chill with you. When you playing video games, I'm playing video games with you. Make sure it's the right video games. Amen. Hallelujah. Wherever you go, the Spirit of the true and living God is with you. Make sure you go to the right places. Everything that you do, the Spirit of the Lord is with you. Amen. Because you're adopted in it. We have to be more conscious of what we do and what we say. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We bless God. In conclusion, in closing. Amen. We may be going through storms of life. Amen. We may be going through storms of life.
Yes.
You know, what hope do we have when we go through temptation, when we go through trials, when we go through sufferings threatening our lives, and our life seems like it's turning upside down? If you have trusted in Christ, let me encourage you along with this message today. Do not fall back into fear. You have an Abba Father. When you call on him, he adopts you. There's a sign sealed approval, and he is saying, I am coming to your rescue. Please stand. And you can rejoice in that.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You can rejoice in knowing that if you trusted in Jesus, and if you're being led by the Spirit, you have been adopted into God's family, and you are called a child of God. You are, and believe it. I want you to believe it. You are a child of God. Come on, tell yourself, I'm a child of God. I will do right, because I'm a child of God. Hallelujah. And you are a child of God. You have a new identity. You have a new family. No matter what your earthly situation is, you can rejoice in knowing that you have an all-powerful God that has been with you.
Thank you.
Amen.
I want everybody to come up to make a straight line. Hallelujah. I promise I won't bite. I did take